Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Dumpster Shark Plays Dark Souls Remastered. In the last episode, we beat Quelaug at the bottom of Blighttown, and I unlocked this hidden door after ringing the bell, the second bell, and I said, oh, we're going to explore Blighttown some more. You know, actually, I changed my mind. Because I want to have the ring that allows me to move normally in the swamp. I want to have that before I finish exploring Blighttown. And moreover, I kind of just want to get out of here. So I'm going to wait till we actually have that, but we also have the ability to warp to and from certain bonfires. And then once we do that, I'll come back and explore Blighttown and other areas. We have to come back down here anyway to progress in the story, so we'll do that at another date. But while I'm here, let's talk to this guy.
Oh, dear. What have we here? Are you a new servant? But you have no eggs. Ah, no matter. Go along and have audience with our fair lady. I pray that you will mind your manners.
Okay, this guy is slow moving. But wouldn't you be? If you were crawling around on your stomach and had this giant sack of eggs on your back? I think you would. Okay. Okay, I was just tricking you. I'm gonna level up a couple times, I think. Because I don't want to level up attunement. Because I have all these souls, basically. Let's do vitality to 16. Let's do dex. Let's leave dex where it is. Let's do that. I think that's acceptable for now. Yeah, I still want to lose all those souls. So, we can reinforce our Estus Flask here. Obviously, we don't have any Estus... or whatever. I almost called them Estus Flask Shards. That's not this game. We don't have any Firekeeper Souls. I'm going to enter this covenant, though. Because of that, right there, for one, but also because if I offer her a certain amount of humanity, I will be able to open up a shortcut later on that is actually immensely helpful, so that will be good. But yeah, so we're going to have to make our way out of Blighttown. It's kind of a pain, and that's why I wanted to get rid of some of those souls, you know, or use some of those souls, rather, not just get rid of them, because there's a good chance I will die trying to get out of here. That being said, let's go ahead and equip the spider shield, because I'm going to be trying to go... Gosh dang it, I equipped in the wrong slot. Okay. I'm going to be trying my best to get a third Firekeeper soul. It's just kind of in a tricky location. But before I do that, I'm going to go back to this other bonfire, just because it's a little bit closer, so if I do die, I don't want to have to make this trek every single time. That being said, I'm just hoping to get through this without dying at all, and that would just be nice. We can also, like, get an egg head from one of these dudes. I'll do that later on. I'll get infected, and whatever. Infected, it sounds better. But infested sounds good too. So they both sound like great things. Like I love the idea of that. Anyway, now once that happens, I can go talk to that other Eggman, Engi or whatever his name is, and yeah, and he'll be like, "Oh, you're one of us. Cool. We like you now, even more than we liked you before." So that's a good thing. But I really just want to get back to Andre before I... And he's, like, in the direction we're headed anyway. He's, like, right there. So that... It's perfect. And also, did you see that, by the way? Oh! Mosquitoes! Nothing. Don't worry about it. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna go take this guy out, because he's a bear bug. And bear bugs... you know, are naughty. I don't think there's anything over here. There will be a merchant at some point, if I manage to make that happen, but for now that is not the case. And I'm going to be climbing up this area to get out of here. But before I do that, like I said, let's go back to this bonfire, because it's pretty close by. Don't swat at me. I know it's tempting and fun and la-di-da, but don't do it. Okay. Okay, so that'll heal my poison. My order of operations in Dark Souls is probably not the best. That being said, usually when I come down here, I go into Lava Land and, you know, kill a boss there, and then I backtrack. But I'm not going to do that this time, just because, you know, we'll get our opportunity to come down here, back down here anyway. That being said, let's make our way up here and see if we can survive this little area. It's a lot harder without, like, projectiles, and I don't have a Pyromancer's Flame yet. Maybe should have gotten one, like, backtracked after going to the depths, but backtracked to the Firelink Shrine, but I didn't really feel like doing that, so I did not do that. I'm gonna go ahead and equip this now. And I really should equip some blooming purple moss clumps as well. That's better. I hate the flies. The mosquitoes. I hate them. I hate that they're... This one's low enough. No, it's not. I hate these enemies! I'm gonna fall! Get out of here. Thank you. And they're gonna keep coming, so I just gotta move on. And there is a bear creature, bear bug, bugbear, whatever you call them, back here. So, I'm gonna wanna go that way. I think that's the way to go in order to get back, or rather, not in order to, in order to get the Firekeeper's Sewell. Sewell! Sulu! No, let's stop. Stop this. Okay. Yeah, this is the right way. Or the freaking wrong way, depending on how you look at it. Gosh dang it. It's the right way, but you don't want that to happen. And I can't waste any more of those. Okay, so I need to just be quick here. This isn't actually the right way to get up to those dudes, but there is something over here that I want, so that's cool. But mostly what's in here. Gosh dang it. Fudge off. Okay. Remedy. I mean, that's actually not what I was thinking it was. There's something further up. It's a different point that we want. A key, specifically, but actually, I don't know if it's a key we need, though. We'll find out. Oh, Lanta. Oh, gosh. No! Oh, falling down is so much fun, you guys. Don't you just wish you could fall all the time to your death and just, oh, it's such a glorious thing. Oh, I love it so much. Okay, that's not true. Bear bugs. Bug bears. Whatever. Don't poison me. Gosh dang it. Oh. I can buy these things for cheap. Not the blooming ones is the, not well. The blooming ones aren't as cheap, I should say, but the regular ones I can buy them for pretty cheap. Or farm them. Maybe can I farm them? If I can farm them, where do I farm them? I actually don't remember. Okay. Rickety old contraption here. That this is. I think those mosquitoes are already shooting at me. Yeah. I'm actually gonna just ignore that dude. Except for I need to go back over there to get my souls. No, it's up here. It's up here. We're good. Maybe should have used all of my souls. It's actually not up here, but that's alright. Because up here, we do have one of these dudes. Well, we have multiple of these dudes. Get out of here! Ah! Get out of here! Get out of here, dog! You're not a dog, I know, but also... You are the strongest mosquito. Okay, I'm gonna go down and get my souls. You know what? Actually, I'm gonna take care of some of these dudes first. Just because they're a pain. Like, they're actually the worst. Soul of a Proud Knight. I don't know why I got that. Or had such an urgency to get that, rather. Okay. We gotta wait till this toxicity goes away. Although we did get some clumps there. Oh, I don't remember if these dart dudes respawn. So I don't think the other ones do, but these ones actually might, and that sucks. But they're actually not too bad. I mean, you know, they're bad because of what they do to you, but they're not too bad in the fact that they take one hit to kill. Get rid of it. I'm trying to get rid of the freaking... There we go. Now I think they're just down there, right? Or is there just one left? There's that dude. No, I think there's one down the tunnel, too. But we have the dogs. And this is problematic. So before I deal with the dogs, I'm gonna go get my souls, because I probably will die here. At least once. You know, maybe I should change to the club. Or at least equip the club in addition to... Gives us a slower roll, mid-roll. But that's alright. I think this will deal with the dogs a little bit better. Clubbing them on the head. Also, is that... Yeah, that dude's still down there. Alright. Let's get our souls and get the heck out of here. Oh my goodness. Okay. And there is actually somewhere... Oh my goodness. There's a ladder here, and I think the key might be up there, so I need to go get that. I hate this camera. Oh my gosh. You know what? Just climb. Just climb. I hate this, but, you know. Oh, gosh dang it. There we go. There's one. Gosh dang. I cannot. The camera is actually killing me. Oh, no. Oh, no. Don't you dare hit me through the wood. Alright. Alright, I think the key's up here. No, actually there's nothing up here. What am I talking about? I promise I think I know something. Like, what is the point of coming to this area? Well, there's more over here. Let's... yeah, okay. I don't know if there's actually any reason to come up here. I thought there was. Maybe just to snipe those dudes down there. There's no other ladder up, as far as I can tell. It's not a hidden... There's not a secret wall. I don't know. If I'm missing something, it's not a big deal. Like I said, we're not trying to 100% this. I just have OCD and... Yeah. We need to get back across this silly branch. Which I just jumped off of last time. You know, kind of. Alright. Get out of my way, creature. I mean, I like the the ragdoll physics, but also some of these bigger bodies are like, it's impossible to see what's going on when they're attached to you. Okay. A little bit of a frame rate hiccup. Okay. So here's what you do. Here's what I do. What I'm going to do. Oh, get out of the way of that. I'm gonna come down here. And I hate this. This is not working out as well as I thought. I thought like one bash of the skull would get him with the club. Okay, two does it. What does my sword do? Let's go up here. Let's get out of the way. I didn't use my strong attack with the club, granted, so I should do the same thing with this guy to make it kind of fair. Get out of here with your fire. Okay, he does about the same. So in that case, I'm actually just going to unequip the club, get myself the fast roll again. Don't get trapped here. I hate this. I don't mind healing up like as much as necessary. Gosh dang it, you're still alive? You fool! Oh my gosh, I can't hit the little dog! Bash him in the head with the club. Bash him in the freaking skull. Okay, gosh dang it. I already put the club away, that's why I did not do that. There's the Firekeeper soul. Thank goodness. It's the reason I came down here, but we might as well take care of it. These last enemies, and I'm just gonna. I don't like these dogs. I hate these dogs. All right. Now there's a. What the heck? Where did the dart man go? Give me a sec. Did he like clip through the earth? No, did he just back up? I don't know that I've ever seen him move. All right, so we're done with this freaking area. Well, now we just have to get out of here. Oh, thank goodness. I think the key that I am thinking of is maybe a key I don't need since I have the master key. But also, if I do need it still, I believe it is up a few more levels, or maybe just another level, I don't know. But now we can upgrade our Estus Flask another time, and where am I going? Actually though, where am I going? Oh, right there. Excuse me. This is why they have these torches, so you can see where the ladders are, and I just ignore them sometimes. But yeah, I'll come back down in Blighttown, and we'll clear the area out, do the things that need to be done. The main thing I'm not gonna 100% are the side quests, like the NPCs quests, just because a lot of those are pretty tedious, and I don't know if tedious is the right word, but they're... They require circumstances that I don't like doing necessarily. And I'm pretty sure we've already failed Solaire's because he died during the Gaping Dragon boss fight. I don't remember for sure what his... I think this is the key. Yeah, key to New Londo Ruin. So yeah, I don't need that. But if you didn't have the master key, you would need that. And we have a couple of these dudes to deal with up here, that's fine. Except for when you don't get a backstab. You know you want the backstab. There you go. But yeah, I'm excited to upgrade our sword. I don't think this is the best weapon in the game. Like, don't get me wrong, I just like it. I like it. I think it can be pretty good if you, like, you know... put enough into dexterity and maybe even get, if you were to get like crystal magic weapon, which, but you have to have like, I think 50 intelligence for that or something crazy. If you were to get that, then, you know, that helps out a lot. Okay. Okay, both dudes are aggroed, so I might just run past these guys. Yeah, I'm just gonna run past these guys. It's not a big deal. I just don't want to fight both of them at the same time. Could chain backstab them, but I'm bad at that. So instead, we'll just get out while the getting's still good. And you might remember this area from one of the first videos. But the key to New Londo Ruins, I'm pretty sure, opens that door, that gate. And I already opened that, so... yeah, here we are. New Londo Ruins. So I gotta make sure that I don't die when I come this way, because the elevator's probably at the top. That is correct. So don't just run in there, because you will die. I went the wrong way, but that's alright. I will probably put some of that stuff in my bottomless box. Do I have a better ring now than the Ring of the Evil Eye? Still don't have any other rings. Ring of Sacrifice that I don't want to waste. I'll leave that up here. But I mean, we're back at Firelink Shrine, so that's good. So it's relatively easy to get back down to Blighttown. And that's, if you have the Master Key, that's the way I would usually go to get to Blighttown, just because it's so much quicker and you have to deal with a lot less. But, you know, since I was doing it kind of the way I did it the first time, obviously I took the way through the depths. And I want to fight, like, every boss. Like, I don't want to skip bosses necessarily, so that, again, that's part of the reason I'm doing this. But let's go ahead and repair everything really fast. Oop. And then I'm going to access bottomless box. And mostly I'm just going to put weapons that I don't necessarily want. Which is most things. Just because I don't switch it up very often. I'll keep my club for now. I should keep at least one of the crossbows, just in case I decide to use that. Is this one... is there any reason to switch to that? I don't know. I don't think there's any. Baldur's shield might actually be okay. I don't know for sure. You know, I don't need it. I don't need to put any armor in here. I don't go through armor very often. But just in case I need some better armor, I'll just leave that. So mostly just weapons. Okay. So let's go talk to Andre. Or I guess we could talk to these people really fast.
You are undead as well. Then we've no time to fraternize. I have my mission and you no doubt have yours. Must not let this curse overcome us. Did I not explain the urgency of our tasks? Or are you so uncouth as to lack such judgment? By the looks of you, I should think not.
Alright. Well,
did I not
let's talk to these blokes.
What have we here? You look awfully raggedy. Times are grim. The least you can do is look sharp. Don't you dare meet my lady like that. You might scare her off for good.
Well, it's a bit late for that.
Oh, you again. What business have you? I don't suppose we can help, though. We accompany my lady on her righteous mission. It is quite a chore, but I'm stuck with her. And Nico, too. I can't very well abandon them now. Oh.
Alright. And this guy.
Hmm?
Mm-hmm? Okay.
Did I not
Okay, now let's talk to this guy, see what he's got to say.
Oh, hello. My guests have finally arrived.
You're so creepy.
I will be departing with them shortly. So, I'm afraid I will be saying goodbye soon. It was a pleasure.
Yeah, whatever. I don't care. Whatever. So I should go back to Undead Asylum. After I upgrade my stuff with Andre, I believe that's what I will actually do. And then I will head to good old Sen's Fortress. So Undead Asylum, we have another boss to fight there. In addition to that, though, we have a couple of items to get. One of which is the ring that makes rolling in the swamp and other swamp-like areas easier. Well, moving, not just rolling. Walking, etc. And we're going to be going into an area in Sen's Fortress where that will be necessary. A place where there is tar, I believe, or something. So, yeah. Gonna rest there. I could go into the catacombs as well.
Ah, why, that's a fine ember.
This guy actually moves his mouth when he talks, which I like.
Smith some mighty weapons with one of those. Why not lend it to me?
Even if it doesn't necessarily look the best.
You won't be disappointed. I can hardly wait to get started.
I at least like that he makes the effort. Okay, let's do that. I mean, now I can just reinforce this at the fire, but I'm gonna reinforce it up to 8. Unfortunately, that means I can't modify the club, but that's alright. Let's see. I should purchase the crest of Artorias. I gotta figure out where to get a bow. Yeah, I'll purchase that.
Don't get your knife.
Since I have the money to do so. Could go down here and deal with a Titanite demon. Maybe I'll try. I'm not gonna say I'm gonna defeat it. I'll see how much damage I do. And how much I take. Obviously I take a little bit. I don't do very much. Not at least without my magic weapon, and I don't know that this will help that much. If I can get out of here without getting hit, that is. Let's try. It gives me about 15 to 20 more damage. If I'm patient, I can defeat this guy, but if I die here, I'm just gonna run back in and grab my souls and get out. I'm not too worried about this guy, I'm not too concerned with defeating him right now. I just wanted to see, you know, what I could do. Should heal up, but probably not going to. Kind of would like it a little bit better, I think, if there weren't all these, like, pillars. I healed up at the wrong spot, but you know what? Still got more health than we did before. Magic weapon actually just barely wore off, so that's cool. I hate this. I hate this guy. Strong feelings, I know. Okay, we got him. Pretty easy. Like, the first time you come through here, it's like, this guy is, like, intimidating, you know? He's, like, shooting lightning at you, and has this giant, weird weapon. The bow! I remember where it is. Okay. Sorry. Excuse me. We might as well go down here and defeat Havel, too. While we're down here, at least try to. Oh, my gosh. Could even get another bonfire. There's quite a few things I could do down here, but the main thing, I want to get the bow and maybe defeat Havel. And see some tree enemies that drop they do drop purple moss clump. I was like, this is where you farm it. This is where you farm it. And sometimes they drop the blooming ones as well. And there's another one coming. So I'll just wait for him. These dudes do a grab attack from time to time. Okay. And there's also a chance I could get a Black Knight Halberd, which I actually really like that weapon. I wish you could buff it and stuff. Jimmy buff it? No. I wish you could use like weapon buffs on it and stuff. That would make it a lot better. But there's also a Crystal Lizard down here. Let's see if I can get him. Don't want to run too early because I'll run out of stamina. But if I can get him, okay. Some more large Titanite shards. That's good. I guess I could probably go deal with the other Black Knights as well. I don't know that I'll do very much damage to this guy. I think this is the bow. I think. No, yeah, it is. Okay, the longbow, anyway. I was like, no, it's not. It is. Kind of knew what I was talking about. Just kind of, though. There's a couple of bonfires down here. In this area. Well, there's one down here, and then there's one up there, but... the Black Knight is down here with the Halberd. I would love if he dropped it, but if he doesn't, that's fine, because I'm not going to use it anyway, most likely. I would also love if I just survive. That would be... yeah, I don't know. That would be great. I need to do a backstab here, buddy. I don't know your... there we go. Kind of hard to get a good angle when I'm on this hill. At least it's hard for me, I should say. Don't kick him off the edge. I guess it doesn't really matter, because he'll drop... like, you'll gain his equipment anyway. It'll just come to your inventory. But there you go. Let's see. Blue Tide Knight Chunk. No, Black Knight Halberd. But that guy does not respawn. At the very end of the game, you will fight more of those dudes with the... more Black Knights with the Halberd. And those guys respawn, so you can farm a little bit. This shield is actually pretty good. It's a pretty good shield to have. So... yeah. I'm not going to actually rest at this bonfire. But I am going to come over here just for a second. There is a ring to get past a bunch of drakes. But I'm not going to go for that yet. I might... in fact, you know, I'm not even going to deal with them right now. That just takes you back down to the Valley of the Drakes. But the other side... well, the opposite side of where I was before, where I just, you know, went to New Londo. But yeah, that shield, it doesn't block 100% physical or anything, but it gives you a increased stamina regeneration. So a lot of the times, if I am not using, like if I'm not using this shield, if I'm just two-handing a weapon, that is a good shield to have on your back, because it'll help out even when it's not, you know, in your left hand. Now this area can be kind of scary, especially the first time you come through here, but we're not going to let that happen to us. Instead, we're going to open this door and then immediately look out. This is Havel. I could have come down and fought him much earlier on, but I don't think that would have been very beneficial. We've been doing okay without his ring, which you get from him. And I probably would have just died anyway. I might still die. I just, you know, I have a better chance now, I think. Well, I know, but I also just died. One hit. I don't know if I was... I don't think my health was completely topped off, but maybe it was. Even if it was, I think that might have killed me. He's not too bad if you can get some backstabs on him. I just suck at backstabbing, so... But we'll go ahead and go back down there. We gotta retrieve our souls at the very least. And there's also the wolf ring down in this area. Well, kind of in this area. That's a good ring. I think it'd be prudent to get the other bonfire. Not the one that I just lit down there, like, near that elevator, but there's a one, like, that's up further ahead without going, taking this path to the right. But I don't think it would actually change things much for us. So I'm not going to worry about it yet. When I loop back around, I'll get it. But for now, I'm just going to take this guy out and then head to the right like I just did. Please drop some clumps. Nope. That's alright. This time when I go against Havel, I will use magic weapon beforehand, before going through there. Not that I got, you know, very many hits on him before, but I should have done that anyway. Because it'll, you know, increase the damage if I do get a backstab. It'll increase the damage anyway, but specifically if I can get some backstabs in on him, that would be nice. So we're just going to go this way this time, not drop down, because we already have the bow. Which is actually fantastic. Because there's so many things that they're just pesky. Like, and it's just nice to be able to chip away at them from a distance with a bow before you get into, like, a terrible situation. So, there's that. Maybe premature in my use of that, but that's alright. That should have been a backstab. I know my backstabs when I see them, and that was a backstab. Havel, get away from the freaking wall, man. Okay. I hate Havel. I hate him. Fighting him in Dark Souls 3, like, I don't know what it is. He's too powerful. It's his armor, man. And you can get that armor later on. But he's also, like, incredibly, like, good at flipping around, like, you know, just immediately. Which I don't like. I also don't like him being this close to the wall. It's harder to get behind him, obviously. We're doing okay so far. Like I said, he's not hard. He just hits hard. And so you just gotta avoid getting hit by him basically at all. That only gave me like 10 more damage to the magic weapon there. If I was looking at the stats correctly. Howl's Ring, I will equip that. It's not gonna do me much good right this second. But it'll be good later on. And I don't need to go up there, because that's just back up to the Burg. Back up to where we fought the Taurus Demon. I'm going to avoid this area for now. I'll grab this item, and you'll kind of see why I'm avoiding this area. Maybe you won't. I guess I wasn't close enough to aggro the main enemy there, but that's alright. It's a Hydra. I could probably take the Hydra now, but I don't need to, so I'm not going to. Instead, I'm gonna go back up. I'm gonna open up a little bit of a secret area and unlock the door with the Crest of Artorias, and then by secret area, I mean like just a hidden bonfire. But also, yeah, there are secret areas in this area. Areas in the area. Bum, ba-dum, ba-dum. There's also an optional boss battle up here that's fairly easy. Well, very, very easy. But I'll come back to that. The main thing I'm going to focus on here is getting that bonfire. Because I believe it's a bonfire you can warp to later on when you... And if I light it, then I should be able to warp to it. I believe that is the wolf ring up there, but I have to... I'm not gonna get that this round. Okay, yeah, I know you're coming for me. Purple moss clump. It's just nice to unlock these things. I guess I don't need to have these equipped. Also, blood red moss clump. Nice for bleeding. Is there another dude that spawns? I don't remember. No, I think it was just that dude. Alright. Let's continue forward. So these episodes probably aren't going to go up for a while. If I had to guess, I'm probably not going to upload them until like next week sometime. So there's going to be a pretty big gap. Just because I don't have time to record very often, unfortunately. So, it sucks. It does. But this is the door you open with the Crest of Artorias. It's the only way to open the door. You cannot open it from the other side. You can get over there without using the crest. Like, there's a way back around behind the Hydra that gets you up here, but then this door, like, just remains closed. So, if I come back up that way, I would like to be able to exit through this door. I am going to come down here really fast and just not go through that fog wall, but just still grab an item from here. Can I? Yeah. There's an ambush in here in case you're curious, but you can avoid it if you just do this. It's not too difficult to, you know, to take care of these guys anyway, but I just like to avoid ambushes when possible. It's just a soul item. I'm just going to leave the fog door. I could traverse it and... Yeah, I'm not going to. I'm going to backtrack. We're going to go to the Undead Asylum. Oh, and I forgot about this item. It's hidden behind this rock, but that's alright. We have it now. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's the Wolf Ring. And you need to go through that fog door back there and find a hidden area to the right to get up to that Wolf Ring, and that's something I will do at a later point. The Wolf Ring increases your poise, so it's pretty good in this game, but it's not necessary. So, instead, we're just gonna do like I said and do some backtracking. And I might as well level up. Here, let me look at my equipment really fast. Wait, I think I might be able to take that up to a +9 now. Because I got a couple more large Titanite shards, did I not?
Well, you need it.
No, what? I don't know what I need. Oh, wait, I need to reinforce. Yeah, I can. Okay, so let me check this out. Be with dexterity, be with intelligence. I actually didn't know this scaled with intelligence. Why did I not know that?
Don't get yourself.
I guess it's time to start leveling up my intelligence. Let me double check that. Maybe that's why I like this sword so much. Wait, let's see. No, why did it? Why did that other screen make it same? Was I looking at a different item? No. It doesn't scale with intelligence. I don't know what I was looking at. But let's level up. Probably just twice for certain. But what should I level up? Let's do some dex. Maybe? Just that. Looks good. Okay. Yeah, hopefully I'll get through the Undead Asylum in this episode. That would be kind of cool. And then next episode I'll start Sense Fortress. Which will put us that much closer to An Orlando. Don't get me wrong, I would like to level up intelligence at some point. Because I would love to be able to use... a better spell than magic weapon. Like when I get like great magic weapon or something like that. I don't think I'll ever get enough intelligence to get crystal magic weapon, which, you know, would be the ultimate goal, but in this playthrough, that's probably not going to happen. So we've got to do some stuff. Let's go back on the elevator. Sorry, I had to think for a second. I was like, what do I need to do to get here? It's got to come up here. And I don't remember. Yeah, I was going to say, I don't remember having like too much troubles with that jump, but I have had problems in the past. I guess, you know what, I'll come down here and grab this key first. Because I need it, I believe, to get to the ring that I want. And then... Oh wait, yeah, we want to come here, actually. I was like, I want to do this without taking fall damage if I can. Okay, there we go. So now the same thing, basically, but without falling onto the roof. I used to have problems with this. Like, don't get me wrong. Like, you used to just be like, oh, well, I have to jump. Like, now you just roll and you make it. Like, I always used to, you know, I was under the impression that you had to actually jump there. And so I would always, like, jump weird. Like, because jumping in this game is wonky. Let's just admit it. Like, it just is. And, you know, that's fine, but also, rolling is easier. Okay, curl up like a ball. Hello. Tricked him. Tricked the bird, the mama. I said him, huh? It's most likely a female. Why she has two nests and she moves her eggs between both of those nests, I do not know. But it's alright, you know. She knows what she's doing. I hate these enemies. I don't know why I hate them so much, but... they're gonna do a little bit of damage to me based on their fire, but they're not going to do much as long as I block or just hit them before they actually get an attack off. Okay. Now we can come over here though and...
You, give me warm, give me soft.
Okay, we all know Sparkly the Crow, Snuggly the Crow, etc., etc. I think it's Snuggly in Demon's Souls and Sparkly everywhere else. Maybe? I don't remember. Oh my gosh. Can we capture that next time, please? It was the greatest flip in the world. Anyway, I will probably be dealing with her later on. But for now, not necessarily. Okay. I'm gonna come here. Before I fight the boss in this area, I'm actually gonna do a few other things. For one, I'm gonna deal with these guys as best that I can. If I can get in there, it's just hard. This is a very tight area. Could try to parry him. That works, sometimes. These dudes are actually fairly simple to parry, but they also do a lot of damage, so if I miss the parry, then I'm probably just gonna die. Well, maybe not. If they do a heavy attack, yeah. Okay, you know, I'm gonna try to parry him again. Okay. I took some damage there, I'm almost dead, but you know what? Got the second one off. Black Knight Shield. Red Titanite Chunk. Okay, so we've got a dude to deal with up here. You may remember him from the very first episode, from the very beginning of this game. Hello. He's got the fat roll, so, I mean, he shouldn't be a problem. He likes to kick, though, so. Don't kick me! I don't want to heal up because these bonfires aren't kindled. So that's why I'm not healing up. And I want to have 10 Estus flasks going into the boss. Gosh dang it. There we go. Sorry, buddy. Overkill, I know. I like your shield. Crest shield. In fact, I'm probably going to equip that. Over the regular? Let's see. Just because it blocks more magic? For now, I think that's more beneficial, so. Yeah, so that, you know. That guy helped us out at the beginning, now he's not quite helping us out. That being said, I'm gonna rest here. Before I go up and get this ring. I mean, there's a couple things. There's actually a couple things. I guess I'll go with the ring before I fight the boss, and I'll just, since I'm here, I'll just go down here really fast. Since I'm here, I'll go down here. Because there is an item we need back at the very beginning of the game if we want to get to a secret area. And I do want to get to that secret area, so. Also, can you guess who we're going to be fighting for the boss? Yeah. He's got gas. He's got some bowel. Some bowel problems. I can relate, my brother. My diet is not ideal. Okay. Red Titanite Chunk. Again, but this is the item. Peculiar doll. How peculiar. Okay, now we're gonna get the ring, and then the last thing we're gonna do in this episode is fight that dude. If I die, I'll still end the episode because we're running fairly long here. And if that happens, then I'll just fight him again in the next episode, but there will be no summon for this boss. This boss isn't, he's pretty much the same as the first guy, except for he has like an AoE attack that is a pain. That's pretty much it. And there's a third variation of him later in the game as well. I forgot that had to be set off again. So, sorry. And by sorry, I mean, please. Okay. It's alright, we didn't take too much damage. And I'll just rest the bonfire again before we go actually deal with the boss. We are going to take damage on this boss battle right away because I don't have anything to protect me from fall damage. That being said, we have 10 Estus flasks, you know, not a problem. There are two of these dudes now. Just two though, not a problem. And there's that key that we got from the top of that building. So now we finally get to get this rusted iron ring. So that is good to have. That'll help us out in Blighttown and also in Sense Fortress a little bit. But let's go back, rest at the bonfire, and then see if we can take care of this boss. There are a few enemies in this room. I already took damage. That's alright. It's not, because, I mean, like, they're super easy to avoid taking damage from, but also, It is what it is. Okay. So, before I go down into the boss battle, let's see if you can guess where it is. So yeah, you take like half your damage, like right there. And then he does this AoE attack that like kills all of your stamina. It's like the worst attack. I hate it. So you kind of want to be close to this guy, I think. Is the gist of it. But also, you gotta, if you're, I think if you're behind him for that AoE attack, you'll be safe. But he has another one that like, but like I said, this is basically the same dude. It's just, he's got that attack. This attack that you want to be like just out of there, like it's big and this one sucks because it goes right in front of him and then, you know, your shield is kind of worthless. So I might die here. I don't know. As you can see, I'm not doing a ton of damage. I'm doing very little damage, actually. Which sucks. And the arena's kind of small. It's not, like, tiny. Don't really want to lock on, actually, maybe. Kind of want him to keep doing that. Okay, that was silly. I rolled into him. But if he keeps doing this attack, it's fairly easy to avoid when you're behind him. So that's what I'm hoping for. If he keeps doing this and jumping up into the air, then we will probably beat this guy. It'll take a while, unfortunately. I could use my magic weapon again while he's doing that. Don't do the exact same thing. I did do the exact same thing. That's alright. It's because when I'm backing up, he tricks me. Don't do that. Gosh dang it. So this is where it gets dangerous. I'm in front of him. He can do his other AoE attack now. But he's also backed up against the wall. So if I, even if I'm behind him for his first one, then I'll be too close. He's back in the middle of the room though. This is good. And he's doing this attack. So I'm actually going to use this and hopefully get some attacks in. Okay, he did that one. Still not doing a ton of damage, but if I had a pyromancy here, I would be like in a pretty good spot. Pyromancy is just kind of great all around in this game. Not in every situation, but for the most part, it just is helpful. I wish he would stop doing this one. Just because he turns so much and then it's hard to get back behind him. I want to be behind you, buddy. Okay, that's good, that's good. That's also good. Just because it gives me some time. Gets me two hits in. Okay. Had my shield up so I didn't take any damage from running into him. Before when I do, it's when I roll into him. And this guy drops a very valuable item, though. That's the main reason I'm fighting him. Otherwise, the main reason for coming back to this area right now was for that doll and for the ring. So we're doing very little damage. But we'll do this one again. Okay. I just want him to do that attack so I can get two hits in on him, maybe, hopefully. It's not, the magic weapon isn't a huge help, but it, you know, any bit of extra damage is nice. Maybe should have used a gold pine resin here. I think I still have one left. So the main thing with this game, I think, is just patience. Like, if you are so overpowered that you can take this guy out in, like, you know, a few hits, then that's, you know, good for you, I guess, but... Like, this weapon against him is not the best weapon against him. I probably should be using a thrusting attack instead, though. And if I was doing that, I'd probably be... Yeah, a lot better off. So that's my bad for not doing that, but... It's just, for me, it's just a little bit harder to hit him... where I want to hit him. Okay, that sucked. That sucked. This is gonna suck even worse if I get hit. We're good, though. So I need to get behind him before he does anything else. Okay, just use some thrusting attacks. So one thrusting attack basically does just as much, if not more, damage than two normal attacks. So I'll keep trying to do those. Should make quicker work of him. There's two thrusting attacks. So I can probably get two in here as well. If I can even hit him, that is. That's the main thing, you gotta hit him. I know you're thinking, like, how are you missing him? His butt is huge, but... You know. That's why I was using the other attack, because I can hit him easier, it just doesn't do as much damage. But... There we go, Homer Bone, Humanity, and then Titanite Slab. So once I get the largest of the embers, I will be able to increase... Well, I'll be able to upgrade my weapon even further. And then, with that the large Titanite Slab, I will be able to, maybe think for myself and figure something out. No, I'll be able to get to the highest level. For my Baldur side sword. I don't think there's anything up here that I need to worry about, is there? Like, no items? No. Let's just go. So I'm gonna head back to Firelink Shrine and then I'll end this episode. So these episodes run a little bit longer than I'd like. That being said, I would rather have them be an hour long than like 20 to 30 minutes long. Cause I could just end them, like, you know, I could just cut them at 30 minutes every time. I could just do it like a lot of people do, a lot of YouTubers and what have you do, and just, you know, just basically play like for a 5 hour long period and just every 30 minutes cut the video. And but I have done that in some games, but I don't want to do it here. In fact, I'd love to have another, be able to play again after this, but I don't think I'm gonna be able to, unfortunately. I gotta get ready for bed, and I have a long weekend ahead of me, even though it sounds like a good thing. Like, by long, I mean I'm gonna be doing a lot of driving. So, coral up like a bowl again. As I drink the most water one man has ever... That's not true. Drinking. Had to finish the sentence anyway. Yeah, so I like my current position in the game. I like it a lot. So there's that. We're just gonna go ahead and do the same thing here to get down. Maybe not the exact same thing. Actually, yeah, I'm gonna do the exact same thing. By the exact same thing, I mean I'm not gonna do the exact same thing.
Oh, you again? Me? I've become separated from my lady. I've scoured near and far, but no sight of her. Where could she have gone? My lady, to think I swore to protect you with my life.
Alright. Yeah, so that's sad. You know what, before I go, actually... There is something we can do. and it's fantastic, so let's do it.
Well, I see you made it out. Yeah, I made it out safely too. I have my pyromancy of the Great Swamp, so I can usually manage with a bit of care. Oh yeah, by the way, I can share my spells with you. I think you have a knack for it. All you need are the materials. I'll be pleased to help you. Ah, and unless you find the magics unsavory?
No.
Yeah, wonderful. I'm sure that, you know, they'll be of some use, some assistance. Here, first take this.
There we go, pyromancy flame.
Flame from the Great Swamp. Now you're a fully fledged pyromancer. Why, let's get started right now.
All right. So I can buy pyromancies from him. So the good thing about pyromancy is you don't need like, at least in Dark Souls 1, you don't need any special like stat. There's no special stat requirements. So look at that. I can buy a fireball. I can buy a flashlight. I can use all of these items. Like 0 for intelligence, 0 for faith. So that's good. And the way you actually gain, or like increase your damage with pyromancy instead of by increasing your stats, is by upgrading the glove itself. So, I mean, I do have some souls here. Let's see, are there any of these that I want to buy? Probably want to buy Fire Orb. And the rest are fairly cheap. Might as well buy them all. And then let's... Pyromancy Flame, not Glove, sorry. Let's upgrade this a little bit. Or as much as I can, actually. I don't know that I'll be using this a lot. But, like, it doesn't hurt.
Pyromancy is the art of casting fire. Produce flame, then channel it. Just as our ancestors did. A pyromancer must be in tune with nature herself. My home, the Great Swamp, is an abundant store of nature. You will understand one day. It only takes time. Pyromancy has a, well, rather primitive aspect to it. It meshes poorly with advanced culture, and pyromancers are considered rather unsavory, which is fine, as I never got along with anybody anyway. So, for me, turning undead didn't change a thing.
A pyromancer's flame is a part of his own body. The flame develops right along with his skill. When I gave you that flame, I gave you a part of myself. Please take good care of it. A pyromancer's flame...
Okay, no need to be weird, buddy.
Goodbye, then.
Okay, that's cool, though. So now we have pyromancy. I'll probably equip that, actually, because it doesn't weigh, like, anything. Just there. But now, if I want to attune stuff, I have to level up my attunement slots. Which I probably will do a little bit. Maybe I'll get another, just one more. Let's see. Like, if I... What would I use? I'd probably use... That takes 2 slots, the Great Chaos Fireball. So I probably would just use Fire Orb for now. Power Within can be good. I mean, they can all be good, like, if you know how to use them. I just suck at everything, so. But I'm gonna end it here. Thank you guys for watching. I am Dumpster Shark. I will see you in the next episode of Dumpster Shark Plays Dark Souls Remastered. Until then, goodbye.